I'm Adrian Smith. I'm a biologist at the North Carolina Museum of Natural Sciences and North Carolina State University, and I'm here with my mom to tell her about my science.
Do I have a name? I just get to be mom?
I mean...
Okay.
Do you want your name?
No, just mom. It's good. It's good. Okay.
So you remember the ants that I work on, the trap jaw ants?
Yes.
I brought pictures of the three that are in this study. So I was looking at the differences between what constitutes a queen chemically and what constitutes a worker chemically. We only know this information for a very small number of ants in the world. And that's like a fundamental aspect of ants, what makes up a queen besides a worker, and how workers in the colony can tell what's a queen and what's a worker. Do you remember the type of chemicals I work on?
No, I don't.
They're these. They're the cuticular hydrocarbons. So that's a wax layer that coats the entire body of an ant. When one ant comes up to another one and touches it with its antenna, then it can immediately tell if they belong in my colony and if it's a queen or if it's a worker.
Oh, okay.
So this is what a queen looks like and a worker. One of the ways we can tell that a worker distinguishes a queen from another worker is that when it walks up to it, it adopts a submissive posture. And that's what's happening in this picture. You see the ant that's next to the queen. She's crouched down really low and she has her antennae retracted back on her head. She only does that around the presence of a queen.
Being submissive, you know, to their mothers.
Right. Anyway.
Okay.
These are the different species that I was looking at. So at the top you have the queens, and then at the bottom you have the workers. And as you can see in all three species, the queen signature is different between species.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I can see that. It's all different.
This is one of the coolest species that I studied, Odontomachus ruginotus. These two compounds right here, these two big peaks, are these. These are compounds that we've never seen before on the cuticle of any ant. We've never seen before in any insect. We've never seen before, period. They're new chemicals, newly discovered.
Oh, okay.
The other thing I want to show you is this picture. What do you think that thing is on the right?
I'm not sure. Does it have wings?
It does have wings, yeah. It's a male. So we're all workers and ants are female, all of them, completely. And queens are female. And then males look completely different from all workers and queens. So here's what males look like.
Oh, yeah, they're all pretty much the same.
Right, exactly. Males are the most similar in chemical profile across species.
Yeah.
They're more similar than workers are across species. They're more similar than queens are across species. Yeah. That's kind of cool to think about because these chemicals in solitary insects are used for distinguishing males from females. So this is a pattern that's sort of reminiscent of their solitary ancestor. So let me ask you a question.
Okay.
Why do you think this stuff is important? Is it important?
Sure, it's important. It's part of our world. We need to understand what it does, how we can get along with it better. It's important, yes. Happy research, Adrian.
Okay. I'm glad you got that out.
Put that on YouTube.
Okay. Will do.